दिस इज़ अवर क्लास 5, सब्जेक्ट सोशल साइंस ईवीएस, टर्म 3, चैप्टर नंबर 5, द यूनाइटेड नेशंस। दिस इज़ अवर लेक्चर नंबर 1। स्टूडेंट, इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल बी स्टडिंग अबाउट द यूनाइटेड नेशंस, प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ द यूनाइटेड नेशंस एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ द यूनाइटेड नेशंस। स्टूडेंट, लेट अस स्टार्ट अवर चैप्टर 5, दैट इज़ द यूनाइटेड नेशन। Student, it was the period of the first half of the 20th century that the world saw two world wars. Means two world war happened in the first half of the 20th century. Wars means battle. Battles were fought between different countries of the world. Okay, different countries were involved in that war. So that war is known as world wars. These wars caused huge destruction to mankind and to their surroundings. Means this world war caused huge destruction. It destroyed many things. Many peoples were killed and their surroundings were destroyed. First world war was fought between 1914 to 1918. Between 1914 to 1918, first world war took place. While the second world war was fought between 1939 to 1945. Students, two world war happened in the first half of the 20th century. First world war in 1914 to 1918, while second world war was fought between 1939 to 1945. Student, this world war destroyed many things. It killed many thousands of people and their surroundings were destroyed. Huge destruction was caused in these world wars. Okay, so to prevent the wars in the future, the League of Nations was formed after First World War. Means after First World War, the League of Nations was formed in 1920. It was formed to prevent the world wars in the future. But even after forming the League of Nations, means after the First World War, the League of Nations was formed, but it was not succeed in checking the wars in long terms. Means even after forming the League of Nations to prevent the wars in the future, the Second World War took place. Okay, the Second World War took place even after forming the League of Nations. So after Second World War, this League of Nations was renamed as United Nations Organization. Okay, this League of Nations was then renamed as United Nations Organization after Second World War. Student, why these countries were fighting against each other? Why these battles were fought? These battles were fought in all parts of the world, on land, air, water, and these wars affected the whole world. Why these disputes or wars took place? These wars took place because there was some kind of disputes. There was some kinds of disputes on land, air, water. Okay, they wanted to spread their power. Okay, that's why these wars took place. Second World War was fought between Axis power and the Allies. Axis power means this was Axis power and the Allies. These were the two parties which fought in Second World War. And Axis powers include Italy, Germany, Japan. And the Allies includes Britain, France, USA and USSR. Okay, student, this Second World War caused huge destruction. Huge destruction was caused after Second World War. Okay. So these destruction caused by the Second World War once again compelled the world power to form an organization to stop wars. Okay, student, after Second World War, people thought that there should be some kind of organization that will prevent wars in the future. Because of this, the United Nations Organization, UNO, came into existence. Next is the United Nations Organization. United means countries united. A meeting was held in 1942 In 1942, a meeting was held at San Francisco region of the USA. Different countries participated in that meeting. Okay, what was the motto of that meeting? That meeting was held to form an organization. Okay, it was held to form an organization that will prevent wars in the future. Okay, these countries participated at the meeting and they signed a rule. They signed a set of rule which is known as charter. Okay, charter means set of rules. A set of rules were signed by different countries. Okay, they signed that treaty and which we called it as charter rule. And because of that, the United Nations came into existence. United Nations Organization was an peacekeeping organization that came into existence on 24th October 1945 under the name of the United Nations Organization. United Nations Organization was formed in 24th October 1945. This is an peacekeeping organization. Peacekeeping means that settles the dispute by peaceful means. Okay. This organization was formed to prevent wars in the future. Okay. And when this organization was formed? This was formed on 24th October 1945. Different countries participated in San Francisco region. Okay, San Francisco is a region, is a place in USA in which a meeting was held in which United Nations Organization came into existence. Its headquarters are in New York. Student, because this peacekeeping organization, because this UNO was formed on 24th October, so every year this 24th October is celebrated as UN Day. Franklin D. Roosevelt, the President of the United States, named this organization as United Nations Organization. Initially, there were 50 members. In United Nations Organization, in UNO, there was only 50 members when it was formed. But presently, it has 193 members. India became its part in 1945. Okay. So, student, we studied that UNO, United Nations Organization, was formed on 24th October 1945. This was formed to check the wars in future. Now student, we will study about the principles of the UNO. What are the principles? Principles means set of rules. What are the rules that each member country should follow? Okay. Maintenance of peace and security in the world is the main aim of the United Nations. Means its aim is to maintain peace and security in the world. All member countries should respect the sovereignty and integrity of each other. Means no country should interfere in the other country's rule or decision. Means every country is free to take its own decision or to make its own rule. All countries should respect the sovereignty and integrity of each other. No country must interfere in some other's country's decision. Treat to peace and use of force should be avoided. Means there should be no wars. There should be peace in the world, and use of force should be avoided. Means no country should use its force against any country. If there will be any disputes or there may be any matter, then they should solve that matter peacefully. They should not use weapons or should not use their forces against any other countries. Peaceful means should be used to settle disputes or disagreements. Okay. Disputes and disagreements should be solved in peaceful manner. All the member countries must obey these rules under the UNO. Student, our next topic is main objectives. Objectives means aims. What are the aims of the UNO? Okay. What are the aims? The aims are to maintain peace and security and settle disputes by peaceful means. Means if there is any kind of disputes or between different countries, then they should be solved in peaceful manner. Okay. Next is to promote friendly relations among the nations. Next is to remove poverty and unemployment. Poverty and unemployment, removal of the poverty and unemployment is the other main aim of the UNO. To ensure freedom of all the people. All peoples are free under the objectives of the UNO. To promote respect for human rights. Human rights, everyone have rights, that human rights are the rights which are given to the humans. So, to promote respect for human rights. Student, this UNO, this United Nations has its own constitution and flag. On the flag, there is a world map surrounded by olive branches with the blue, with the light blue background. Students, see, this is the flag of the UNO. Okay, its background is in blue color and it has these olive branches. Olive means jaitun. It has the branches of olive leaves. In between there is the world map. See, this is the emblem of the UNO. This is the olive leaves. In between there is a world map. These olive leaves or olive branches symbolize peace. Olive leaves are the symbols of the peace. Student, this United Nations has six organs. There are six parts or organs of the United Nations which have different function. Each organs or each part of the of this United Nations perform different function. The first one is the General Assembly. Next is Security Council. Economic and Social Council. Fourth is Trusteeship Council. The International Court of Justice. Last is the Secretariat. These are the organs of the UNO. Each organ of this UNO perform different functions. Okay, this we will study in our next lecture. So student, I hope this lecture is clear to you all. Under this lecture, we studied that United Nations Organization, which was formed in 1945, it was formed to prevent the wars in the future. Its headquarters is in New York and it was named as UN by Franklin D. Roosevelt, the President of the USA. And its main principles and objectives we have studied. Now student, your homework is question number 1. When the UNO was formed. Question number 2. Name the members of the Axis power. Question number 3. Write the objectives of the UN. Student, please do this homework and send it on my mail ID. Thank you so much. I hope this lecture is clear to you all. Thank you.